Hey everybody, it's Brandon, the Weekend Cruiser, where I go on a weekend cruise or longer sailing just about every week. And with that, I'm doing a lot of cruises by myself. So I am a solo cruiser majority of the time. And so I wanted to make a quick video on why going on a cruise ship is a great vacation if you want to go by yourself or you want to just get away for a little bit of time. Now, I do a lot of solo cruises for a few reasons. Number one, I just love being here on the cruise ship. It is my happy place, as I call it, so I want to come as frequently as possible. But with that, there's not a lot of people that also want to go that extreme when it comes to going on a cruise ship. So it's tough to find people that also want to come on that frequent of a basis. But I love being out here. I'm ready to go. And I'm also a really good planner at being able to find those deals and discounts further out in the future, lock them in, and know that I'm going to be able to go there. So, why are cruises maybe a good option for you, or why you should consider a cruise for a solo trip? The first is, it's really all taken care of for you. So planning a cruise is extremely easy. So all you really have to do is book the cruise, figure out your travel. So if you're gonna be driving, if you're gonna be flying, and show up. So the food's gonna be there, the entertainment's gonna be there. It's all taken care of for you. You have some other excursions, or maybe you got some things in port you wanna do and some packages you might wanna consider. But at the end of the day, it's just really easy to plan. You know when you're leaving, when you're coming back, where you're going with one booking. And it's a fantastic way to quickly get away. The second reason why I think a solo cruise is a great option for a lot of people, and this is one that I've seen countless times on the ships, and it's one of the most heartwarming stories of why people solo cruise, and this might apply to your situation, is they had a loved one that passed away. So it's a husband, it's a wife, it's somebody that they maybe traveled with or cruised with for decades, and they've now passed away. So this is a great way that you can continue their memory. It's something that, you know, I think when you come on a cruise, it might be something you did together. You can remember all of those things that you did together, and it's a great way to remember your loved one. Or it's just a great way to go on a trip knowing that they'd want you to be happy and they'd want you to get out there and see the world. The third reason why a cruise is great for solo options is it's really easy to meet people on a cruise ship. And what I mean by that is you are part of a community when you come on the cruise. You all show up at the same time and you're gonna leave at the same time. So if you're somebody like me who enjoys meeting people on the cruise, it's really easy to do because you know you all have something in common with the cruise ship that you can always start out talking about. So it's a great way to meet people, build relationships, and honestly, not really feel like you're solo on the cruise. People ask me all the time if I go by myself, and I'm like, well, I do go by myself, but I'm really never alone because I'm constantly meeting people or I know people on the cruise ship. It's a great way to meet folks, because you're not hanging out with your traditional clique that you would. So if you come with one, even two other people, it's really easy to be insular within those and you miss the opportunity to meet all the other people that are on the ship because you're just busy doing your own thing and it's not a priority. Another item on why I think solo cruising is great is because going on a trip by yourself is empowering. You get to do exactly what you want to do on the ship. And this is really true for any solo trip that you may take, but being on a cruise is a really good place to start because again, all those things are taken care of for you and you can pick and choose what you want to do to make this the best vacation that you can have. And there's something empowering about walking onto a cruise ship by yourself, knowing that, you know what, if I want to do this, I'm going to do it. If I don't, I'm gonna have the ability to leave and not do that. So I think that going on a solo trip, especially a solo cruise, is one of the most empowering things you can do for yourself. The last thing that I'll call out here, and this is one that, you know, balances the other ones a lot, is that when you go on a cruise by yourself, it also gives you a lot of time for mindfulness and relaxation. So when you're not traveling with other people, you don't have to talk all the time. You don't wake up and have conversations or plan out your day. You can have a lot more relaxing time, a lot more quiet time. You can get into your book if you want, and you feel like you're not missing out on what your friends may be doing, or they may be, you know, wanting you to go do something different. It's a really great way to have that mindfulness and to have that relaxation to make sure that you may be balancing some of the excitement from everything else. But I think it's a really good thing for us to take a break from the noise of our traditional lives and just be quiet sometimes. Just sit outside, watch the water without feeling like we have to talk or do something different. All right, everybody, this is Brandon, the Weekend Cruiser, hoping to see you solo cruising on a weekend cruise or longer sailing soon.